As part of a week of activities leading up to Labor Day celebrations, the Labor Department held a fair at Constitution Park in Castries on Friday in an effort to sensitize the public on labor laws and their rights. The announcement by the Prime Minister of the planned implementations of a minimum livable wage by August 2024 has been welcomed by the Labor Commissioner Joseph Joseph. The Labour Commissioner is encouraging citizens to familiarise themselves with the Labour Act.
That piece of legislation is one of the greatest pieces of legislation in the 21st century as far as workers are concerned. This is long overdue. It had been proposed before, but it's becoming a reality this year, and the government needs to take the credit for that. Of course, a minimum wage committee was established, and I have to point out that they have done a very good job. They've done a significant amount of work.
The Labour Commissioner responded to criticisms of the department, saying he will do all in his power to ensure the efficient running of the department.
If I do have evidence that a Labour officer is taking money below the bench, it will be investigated and the appropriate actions would be taken. The matter would be reported to the public service. People say that about police officers, about different people. I am saying that I do not have that information before me where a person from the public could point to a particular officer and say, okay, this person is accepting money below the table.
Mr. Joseph highlighted a number of issues affecting the department and which may be affecting the department's ability to deliver the level of service expected by citizens. He states that while he is grateful for the current team, there is a need for more resources to be allocated to the Labour Department.
Government statistics have revealed that our level of employment in terms of numbers is in excess of 90,000. 90,000 employees. We have a labor department with 8 officers and myself as a labor commissioner. If you do the mathematics, that is about 11,000 persons per labor officer. Whilst all these people do not come to the labor department, I need to make that point just to bring the message across that we are seriously on the staff.
The following week will feature radio interviews and media campaigns from the Labour Department to sensitize the public on the importance of Labour Day celebrations, which will culminate with a day of activities at Serenity Park from 9 a.m. on May 1st, 2024. For the DBS News World, Manasseh Stanislaus reporting.